Welcome to WebStylePress. I mentor junior web developers and fresh graduates. First thing they have to deal with is an HTML page, and first question that I have to answer is usually like, do we have to memorize this code? The answer is, God, please, no. Web developers and software engineers don't memorize code. They use generators, tools, and boilerplates to start a project. They have general understanding of what the code does, but memorizing something is not necessary at all. Also, code, workflow, and technologies change with time. So why memorize code? Generating an HTML boilerplate document in code editor is very easy. Two widely used code editors are Sublime Text code editor and Visual Studio Code. For Visual Studio Code, open document with .html extension or create a document with .html extension, type exclamation sign and hit tab. This will generate HTML code to start with. Visual Studio Code does this with the help of built-in support from Emmet. Now, Emmet can be installed for Sublime Text as well. For Sublime Text, same keys will be used, exclamation sign and tab. But to make this work in Sublime Text, make sure you have installed Emmet package for Sublime Text. And to install Emmet package in Sublime Text, first you need to install package control for Sublime Text. Here is the installation instructions for package control. I have already installed package control for Sublime Text. When you have package control for Sublime Text, you can browse and install packages for Sublime Text. Packages are like extensions for this code editor. So the preferred way to install Emmet in Sublime Text is to use package control. Go to preferences, package control, click install package or select install package, search Emmet. I have already installed Emmet for Sublime Text, so it's not in this list, but select that and install it. So exclamation sign plus tab is all you need to remember to generate HTML boilerplate. Even if you are creating HTML page or starting a React project or Vue project, there will be always boilerplates and generators to help you. So don't worry, don't do it manually. Look for boilerplates and ready-to-use snippets that are available everywhere. Also make sure your HTML has got these two lines. If it doesn't, your web page will not be responsive across different devices. Alright, I hope you liked this tip. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.